and welcome. It's going to be just a quick tutorial on how to open this a file. I'm going to go up to File, and if you had a CWPRJ file, you would use Open. However, we're going to import the FCM file. So you can see Import from your computer. That's where mine is in my computer. And we are going to go and look for it. And it is in cards. That's where I've saved it. It's called a step card. And there's the files. So you can see that it comes in your unzipped version. It'll come as a JPEG, which is just a picture of it, just so you can see what you're doing. An FCM file, which is designed specifically for your Scanncut, and an SVG file, which is designed for the Cricut's Design Space software in particular. So choose, if you have an option of an FCM file, please choose that one that's been tweaked ready for your Canvas workspace, and it will come in as the correct size. So just highlight that and select Open, and there's all your pieces. There's lots of pieces to this particular project. If you go into the Layers panel, you can see all the pieces. And what you can do is you can hide the sections you don't want to send to start with. You can close your groups to make it a little bit easier. We'll hide that group too. We won't send that to Canvas. We'll hide those three because I'm just going to send two pieces. Hide that one too. Slowly work down and to work out which pieces you're going to send. Don't want those shapes this time either. Just going to send these two pieces here. And just got that one left that we don't want this time. For some reason, Canvas always does little dashed lines. It just sees them. There we go, that one's gone too. So we've just got the two pieces. You can close up the group to make it a little bit easier to see what you're doing. And you can see it's the two shapes. Just move them apart. Now, if you're going to cut them out in two separate colors, you would need to make sure that you placed enough cardstock on your mat for that shape and then a different color for that shape. Or you can simply hide one of the pieces and just cut one at a time, one section at a time. So once you're at that point, you can see all the eye hide unhide icons have gone or hidden is probably another word for it. So I'm ready just to cut this piece here. I go up to File, and I've got mine selected to go straight from Wi-Fi to my machine, so it's hooked into the Wi-Fi. So you export FCM or transfer via the internet, which is the one I would choose. So if we went export FCM and you were moving it via a USB, this would be the one you would select. And when you choose export, it gives you a message to say that there's lots of hidden icons or hidden pieces of object. Go OK, and then it will give you the option. You can place it over into your USB here. You can do it different ways as well. Just cancel that. You can do it a different way as well and send all the pieces over and sort it out on your Scanncut. That is another option. And I often do that, possibly not with as many pieces as this particular pattern. But if you're using your USB, it would be much easier to do it that way. If you've got Wi-Fi like me, you choose transfer via internet, or if you've got the DX and got it hooked up by the cable, there's that option as well. We'll go with that. We get the same message that there's hidden objects. So it's talking about these objects here, which are all hidden. We'll go OK. And then it will send it along. And then this is the successful, send message, and it's ready to download. And you go, okay. And then once you've cut that out, you work through the shapes. There might be these two shapes we cut next, and we'll hide this one. And then you just work through. I normally like to place them on the mat in Canvas, roughly where I'm planning on placing the cardstock. I don't have to shift it once I get to my Scanncut. While they're easy enough to shift, just find it's a little bit easier just to, if I was using the top of the mat, I would just place them up there and then send them across. But it's whatever's easiest for you. Both ways work. And as I said before, I do a bit of both sometimes. Anyway, just a quick guide to help you along with getting the file over to your Scanncut to cut it out. I'll talk to you next time. See ya.